So, on this important occasion, let's do a special voiceover video today where we're going to recapitulate the whole SN8 flight.
Let's analyze the entire event, the highlights, and of course, let's try to understand what went wrong in the end and why Starship attempted a landing with a too high speed, which then ended in a rapid unscheduled disassembly.
So after the first test flight attempt of Starship SN8 had been scrubbed last second on Tuesday the 8th of December, we were all on edge for the second attempt on Wednesday the 9th of December. Even Starhopper seemed to be quite excited about it, and we sympathize with Starhopper because we felt exactly the same way.
Then Starship indeed took off to the skies. It was surreal to watch how Starship slowly ascended through the exhaust clouds, created by the combustion of liquid methane and oxygen in the three sea-level Raptor engines. These engines created a peak thrust of 9 MN, or 2 million pound force, more than enough to lift the SN8 off the ground. The flight was really smooth in the first minute. So smooth and uneventful that it seemed too good to be true. But it was true. Starship kept ascending. You can see in the lower right the three Raptor engines gimbaling from time to time to correct the course. At T plus 1 minute and 41 seconds, you can see one Raptor engine shutting down in order to slow down the ascent velocity. Because Starship was nearing the final flight altitude of somewhere between 12 and 13 kilometers, we see a bit of a flame event at T plus 1 minute and 55 seconds, where some insulation foil caught fire. But the whole event only lasted a few seconds and didn't affect the flight. We can clearly see how the ascent velocity is already lower than before the engine shut down. At T plus 3 minutes and 12 seconds, the second Raptor engine is shutting down. Now only one Raptor engine remained.
This is really impressive since we now have a single Raptor engine still increasing the altitude of SN8, although a lot slower now. And now the big moment approaches, where at T plus 4 minutes and 40, the last engine is gimbaling to set SN8 into a rotating motion, while immediately after that shutting down. Now Starship is in free fall, and slowly the aerodynamic drag effect of the rear and forward flaps is taking hold. We can beautifully see the actuation of the rear and forward flaps on the upper right and lower side, respectively. Since the rear flaps have a larger surface area, the air drag is higher, causing the SN8 to slowly tilt 90 degrees and transition to the famous skydiving maneuver. And now the most unreal looking part of the whole flight begins. It just looks so unreal how this 50 meter long behemoth keeps falling towards the ground at a speed that is converging towards 200 kilometers per hour. But since the altitude is so high now, almost 13 kilometers, and these recordings use a high magnification zoom lens, it kinda looks as if Starship would descend really slowly, almost surreal how slowly. But in reality, of course, the speed is reaching 200 kph, so this is just an optical effect. Just beautiful and incredible how perfectly the whole flight went until this point. I mean, this looks like a CGI animation from a sci-fi movie with the shiny steel surface reflecting the ambient light in this cool 50s retro futuristic style.
At T plus 6 minutes and 21 seconds, SN8 passes a cloud layer. The forward body flap camera now switches back to the Raptor engines at T plus 6 minutes and 30 seconds for the initiation of the final stage of the flight, the belly flop. At T plus 6 minutes and 31 seconds, we see the first Raptor engine initiate, then immediately afterwards the second one, but unfortunately, not the third one. The engines gimbal to cause Starship to rotate into the upright position again, which incredibly still works flawlessly. But now you can already see that stuff is not perfect because, well, only two out of the three engines burn, and green flames keep popping up in one of the three engines. Until at T plus 6 minutes and 40 seconds, the green flame completely takes over and the other Raptor engine also shuts down. So we now have only one Raptor engine burning in an incomplete combustion, with the two other engines having completely shut off. Thus, of course, the descent velocity is higher than planned. This one unhealthy engine cannot produce enough thrust to slow down SN8 to the necessary velocity for a safe landing. And SN8 crashes into the ground, resulting in an explosion, or, as Elon likes to say, a rapid unscheduled disassembly. Before we get to what went wrong, let's first say that this whole flight was a gigantic, really gigantic success for SpaceX and the Starship project. This is nothing less than a historic achievement, and it brings the whole Starship idea one step closer to reality, and brings us all one step closer to becoming a multi-planetary species. The landings on the Moon and on Mars suddenly appear a lot more realistic and credible than before the SN8 flight. So we should be totally aware that despite the rut in the end, it was a total success. As Elon tweeted, SpaceX got all the data they needed. And data is king, because now Starship SN9 can immediately take over the testing campaign and learn from the things that went wrong with SN8. So then, what did go wrong?
Well, according to Elon, the fuel header tank pressure was too low during the landing burn sequence, therefore the Raptor engines did not receive enough propellant, resulting in fuel starvation mid-burn. Too much oxygen and no methane turned the last remaining engine effectively into an oxygen torch, which then also melted the copper walls of its combustion chamber, resulting in the really cool looking but ultimately fateful green flame. So the whole flight duration was 6 minutes and 42 seconds, and despite the end, it can be classified as a total success. Now SN9 will take over and continue, and from the lessons learned, the chances are actually really good that SN9 will also nail the landing procedure. Because a too low pressure in the header tank can be solved much more easily than if there would have been a problem with the Raptor engines themselves. Thus, things are looking excellent for SpaceX at Boca Chica, and this was a glorious day for human spaceflight, and ultimately for the whole of humanity. The future where we live on the Moon, or on Mars, or hopefully both, has come a giant step closer towards becoming reality on December 9th, 2020.
So please like this video and subscribe to us if you haven't done so yet. And then we will see you in the next regular space report on Monday. Since this special occasion prompted us to do an episode instead of the regular Saturday video.
We wish you a nice day, and then see you on Monday back in the regular format.